righty then. Arguments. Are they worthwhile or are they completely pointless? I'm going for completely pointless. Because until a person has actually figured out on this particular topic, and every topic, the third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and ideally seventh dimension of it, they're simply stuck in right and wrong, which is duality, which is a sign of they're disconnected from their body, their spinal alignment, and their energies and their organs are well misaligned. So as a result, their frequency in their body is all over the place and is subconsciously skewed one direction. So if we're too masculine, which is the majority of Western society, the gallbladder is going to move our frequency over to the side in the nervous system and skew it. We're not going to be able to get it down to the coccyx and back to the brain to have a complete understanding. So arguments, completely waste of time. Science, for instance. If a person is using science, which is very much dualistic, you know, here's a hypothesis, I'm going to prove myself, and prove myself to my dad subconsciously that they didn't realize, and then everyone else can try to prove me wrong. Well, it's sadly stuck in the fifth dimensional in the mind. I haven't got anywhere near the cause, opened their third eye, or actually got 90% of the brain fully functioning, the neofrontal cortex. It's completely dualistic and a waste of time and incredibly narrow-minded and short-viewed, short-sighted. Oh, and the other way to tell, if someone's got receding hairline in the middle, their gallbladder's screwed, and if you've got the side bits, it's their kidneys. So everything in the bottom half of their body, which is the majority of the subconscious mind and where all the nervous system connections is completely disconnected, so they will have a narrow-minded point of view because that's all they can physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually handle. That's their capacity. So getting into arguments with those type of people, that's all they're going to do is right and wrong. Nah, I don't like it. They're stuck in their inner child emotional garbage, and they haven't even connected to it. With an incredibly limited mind. Incredibly. There's always more. The divine is limitless. And perception and thoughts and beliefs are stuck in the fifth dimension. If you haven't been able to transcend the mind and awaken the third eye and the crown, then that person's perception is a maximum of 10% because they're coming from the small part of the reptilian or mammalian brain, which is 10%, divide that by 7 endocrine glands or chakras, and most people are at between 2 and 4% perception power, and they're arguing. It's perfecting, isn't it? Okay, so you've got 3% perception power, and this person's got 4, and they're arguing. Completely pointless, right? It just ridiculous. It's like children. If you're thinking, you're not good at thinking. The key is to get past thought, past the mind, and you'll be able to receive the messages from the universe, but you need the top 2 centers awakened for that. But of course, it's a way to tell if someone is at that kind of level. They would know how it works. If they got an external divine just thinking, oh yeah, God told me, or this external divine flavor figure, of which there are like 50,000 different names, that's their own perception. They just haven't got the power to stand firm and make their own mind up. Small-minded, absolutely. And of course, if they haven't connected those sections, they just haven't got a clue, essentially. Oh, and it's not just if they actually got there, that information would naturally come to and through them somehow. They would either study it or come in their email inbox, or they would get it in meditation. They would know how it works in the universe, in society, in the thoughts, in the emotions, and in the physical body. Then you know they've got it. If they have it, they're missing parts, and that's generally the missing parts in their body. Easy, right? And of course, in sixth dimensional, most of them are diseases and critters and parasites affecting their mind. If they haven't got rid of those, and they can't control their own mind, haven't even got focus, well then, what is in control? Something else. And, of course, the thing is, when you're talking to, well, either myself or someone at a top level, and they're arguing right and wrong, it's got to be like this, well, guess what? If I'm up here, on every topic in every part of my body, every single time, then I'm able to bring down the cause, the mental, emotional, and the physical down on top of you. It's not going to feel fun. If you're stuck in your stories and it's right and wrong, I can see all the stories and I'll just go thump. Here's some perception for you. Wake up. You don't want that. Stop arguing. It's just arguing is simply a limited mind. And the divine is limitless. So unless we've awakened those top centers, incredibly limited mind. How about a universal mind? I tell you, it's bliss, it's handy, you stop thinking, you can control yourself. It's absolutely wonderful. So, arguments. Dualistic ways to talk. Absolutely, from little boys.